Here we go. Hello, everybody. This is Tango, and we are ready to get started with some Empyrion Galactic Survival. I'm in the process of hurtling toward this planet at about a million miles an hour. I'm sure I will land safely and nothing will happen, of course, though. But, oh, here we go, guys. I am so excited to get started on this game. Empyrion Galactic Survival. It is a survival sandbox world with a space twist. We're going to start out on this planet, which is somewhat Earth-like, but also has a lot of aliens and dinosaurs on it and things like that. But this game just has a whole ton of features. They've been doing a tremendous amount of updates on it. Here we go. It hurts. No, my, come back. I need you. Okay, I will take all of you, and you can roll into the abyss. Goodbye. Don't need you anymore. Got all the good stuff out of there. Oh, wow. Here we are, guys. Now, for those of you that remember, I have done a series on Empyrion about a year ago now, and we had a lot of fun. It was a little short-lived. Great fun in that game, but they have made tremendous leaps and bounds to this game. As you can see, guys, I mean, just look around. The visuals of this game have been updated absolutely. They're just incredible now. I absolutely love it. The gameplay changes are just off the charts and everything. So, for those of you that have never... Oh, there's a little Triceratops guy. Let's go check him out. For those of you that are unfamiliar with Empyrion, it is a, like I was saying, a survival sandbox game based in outer space. It really has a lot of huge base building focus. What is all that over there? I'm so excited to check all this out. Yeah, the base building is absolutely incredible. There's just hundreds of different blocks and shapes you can build with. It's all component-based, but you can tint them and everything. You can just build some phenomenal bases. The ship building... let me get some business going here in case I get attacked. Where's my gun? Right in front of me. Okay, we'll do a little flashlight here just in case someone attacks me. How's it going, buddy? Now, this guy, he's not hostile. The ship building in this game is amazing. You can build galactic vessels to travel between the planets. This is just one starting planet here. So this is Akua. It is the closest to Earth. You can see it's kind of a temperate climate. In fact, we actually don't even need to wear our helmet. So let me take that off. Did I take it off? I did. Okay, there's my ugly face. So you can build spaceships that, you know, you'll build on the planet, seamlessly take off, fly toward the sky, transition into outer space, fly directly to another planet. They have lava planets. They have ice frozen planets. They have, you name it. It's crazy. Oh, there's a little alien guy over there. Like I said, it's a survival game, so there's a really in-depth crafting system. There's combat, as you can see. I can, like, switch to guns. I could fight this guy if I wanted to, which I do not right now. I'm gonna avoid him for now. All kinds of good stuff, guys. All kinds of good stuff. I cannot wait to get started. So, here we go. I am on a dedicated server now. We're gonna be having some friends join us. The list is undetermined at this point, but other people will be joining us. And I'll also be live streaming some of this game as well. Man, the graphic, look at that solar flare, is just a bit overpowering, actually. I want to go over to the beach over there. Oh, okay, let's not shoot the gun with the thing. Okay, let's head over to the beach here and start to get established. If we can swing around this guy without him seeing us. Ain't nobody here for you to see, Mr. Green Slimy. Are we good? Good, he's not chasing us. Okay, we got rocks, we got everything. We got magnesium right there. That's pretty good, I guess. So yeah, you can check out the, this is the map of the planet here, okay? It is an actual, like, 360 degree map. So you can, you know, if I start going east, I will actually do a loop around the whole planet and come back to right there. The north and south are capped, though, but east and west, you can rotate all the way around. There's a day-night cycle, which does actually match the revolution of the planet, which is really kind of cool. Like, you can chase in, or, you know, you can outrun the sunset, so to speak. Kind of funny stuff. So, all right, let's, you know, I'm going to kind of poke around a little bit and find a spot that looks hospitable and looks like a good place to start up. This might be it, but I'll get right back to you. Okay, so I walked around a little bit, and this seems just as good as any. There doesn't seem to be anything really promising in the immediate area. So we'll get established here. We may move our base shortly. But let's go here. So let me show you. I'm going to hit tab to bring up my inventory here. Okay, this is all the stuff they start you with here. I do have a little bit of, I think I chose the easy mode in terms of the starter kit, just because I wanted to get a nice little kickstart to get going here. So that you have plenty of resources here. These bars here, where most of our crafting is going to be about. They give us some starting plants for farming, things like that. We have a motorbike construction kit, which I'll show you shortly. That thing is crazy fun. Over here on the bar, you can see I got my pistol. That's just my little pew-pew gun. Not very good at all. Flashlight for at nighttime. A drill. The drill is kind of nice for, like, you can actually, like, terraform the terrain, and it changes shape and everything you can see. And then you get, like, these little rocks that you... Never mind, didn't get any there. But this is how you would go mining, basically. If I... Like, that magnesium thing there. That magnesium deposit. If I went over there, which maybe we'll do in a little bit, we'll go over there and do some mining. I'll show you how that works. This is our survival constructor kit mobobber thing. I'm just going to go ahead and put this down here. This is basically, like, your crafting station. So I can hit F to interact with anything. Now, on the left side, this is the inventory that I had. So what I'm going to do is just put all of my crafting stuff over there. Magnesium powder, too. These are kind of the primitives for getting started for all building stuff here. Okay, so this is the inventory for the constructor itself. If you want to build anything with the constructor, it needs to have items in its inventory. It won't look in your inventory. And then over here are just the vast tons of things that you can build in this game. Now, this is only some of them because this is the survival constructor. It's kind of like the wimpy one here. We're going to soon build a large constructor, which works better, has more things, just craziness. So, actually, let's go ahead and build that motorbike because it's fun. Why not? So, they give you a little kit here ready to go to start out. I'm going to go ahead and build this thing. And now we should see down here any second now. Ready, set, go. Is it not working? Hello? Oh, I got to turn it on. It helps if I turn this machine on. And then this guy should start spinning. Maybe kind of, sort of. No, why isn't it working? There we go. I had to open it and close it, I guess. That's weird. But anyways, you can see a little progress here. So all crafting in the game takes time. And, you know, you can queue up a bunch of stuff, though. So you can give me 5 of those, 6 of those, half a dozen of those, blah, 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 and just get it all going. And then walk away. And it will passively work while you are doing your thing. Look at this. So they start out with a little motorbike here. Later on, we're going to build much, much better vehicles. This one's just kind of like, this is trash, but it's fun to get started. And it's loud. But you get the idea. We're going to use this thing to do some exploring here. The driving controls are a little bit, you know, not so hot, but it's funny because you can go crazy jumping off cliffs and everything. So, all right, we're going to leave that guy there. All right, so I want to get started building a little starter base here. Again, this may not be the place where we go. Watch it, buddy. I'm watching you. we'll go kill that guy in a little bit. This may not be the place we get started, or the place we stay on, but it'll help us get started. So I'm going to go with a base starter block. And I can see on the right-hand side there that requires a core, which I have moved. They gave you to start out here. So I moved that to the survival constructor's inventory. Therefore, I can make the core. And is this going to be another one of these things? Get going now. Any second now? Any second? There we go. It's taking a long time for these things to start up for some reason, but when this guy is done here now, we'll be able to place and mount. There we go. Oh, it was just seriously delayed. Okay. All right, let's put him on our bar now, and now we can pick a spot anywhere here to... This will be like the heart of our base, so... whatever. Right here. Looks good. Again, this is probably not where we're gonna stay, but there you go. Huge, okay? Obviously, it's large. Yes, that's what... yeah. All right, the other thing I had, where to go, the oxygen generator here. I want to get this guy in the water. This guy will generate O2 oxygen capsules or something for us, I think. So let's see here. Do I have any... I have some fuel packs, so I'm going to put 2 of those guys in there. It already consumed the first one. And, okay, it's working, and the next bottle will come out in just 100 seconds or so. So that's cool. So oxygen bottles are good for, like, if I put my helmet on right now, I'm actually breathing oxygen from my helmet, and my oxygen in my lower left corner there will go down slowly. I'm on this planet Akua, which is a oxygen-based environment, I guess, so I don't need to wear it, but oxygen will come in handy later on the other planet, so whatever. They give it to us, we're gonna get that started. The other thing I want to do now, oh, this guy wants some, doesn't he? He wants to mess around. All right, let's go ahead. Let's load up our ammo here. It only holds 10 bullets here. All right. Come on, a straight line. And die. Uh-oh, this is the part where we run. Reloading. I'm holding sprint to run. Little jetpack turn. Where is it? Oh, you can't keep up, can you? There. Oh, excellent. Oh, slimy little one. Let's see what he looks like in the light. I love it. All right, now once you kill anything in the game, you can basically steal their bits. Oh, nice. Meat. Okay, so I can actually make some food now, I think. So let's see here. I'm going to take that raw meat I just got. I got this stuff here. I'm going to put that, shift-click it over into the constructor, go over to the food tab. Oh, yum. Grilled steak and, or salami. We can make, let's make a couple of each here. Make some grilled steak. Nothing like a little alien on the Barbie to get you through the day. All right, so that'll, oh, it's done already. Are you kidding me? That was fast. That was super fast. All right, so I'll put this on my bar here, and you can see my green food bar in the bottom corner there. Now, I want to wait for it to actually switch to the meat and eat it. There you go. My food just went up a little bit. So this food won't last forever, though. Like, if you check it out here, it'll say on the right-hand side, consumable, use I left-click to eat it, but it's got a perish time. So it shows me how much food it gives back, how much health it gives back and everything. But perish time, 24. I'm not sure if that's hours or what, but it'll rot eventually. So that's kind of bad. So you want to eat that stuff. There's other food around here. There's like corn dogs and stuff literally growing natively on the ground that if you pick those up, they're a decent source of food that'll last quite a while. But let's get building here. Now, this is the crafting system. I was kind of describing it a little bit here. I want to start going and building more blocks here. So I think what I want is some steel blocks. Let's see what else they got here. Wood is something they've added in. I have a chainsaw here. I'm guessing that's for chopping trees down. I'm not quite sure yet. But let's go with some steel blocks. Okay, so those need steel plates over on the side there. So we're gonna go to components and make some steel plates here. So I will bang out some of those guys by shift clicking them into the constructor. They're probably actually building right now. It's just delayed for some reason. There we go. Bonk, they're coming out now. There we go. 50. Nice. Okay, so now I can go back to here and build, here we go, some steel blocks. So I'll build 20 of those, maybe. This is kind of weird how this isn't updating, but you can see it's still happening here. The constructor will look in its output for items, so you don't have to drag everything from the output up to there. It's just the output's nice to know, like, what you just recently crafted. Alright, so those are going to get going here. Now, to get a base going, we're going to need a generator for power. We're going to need a fuel tank to store fuel in. So you can see I had... there we go. Okay, where is it? These fuel packs, this is kind of like the energy source for everything, and they come from the promethium crystals, which I think we put some in here. Yeah, so from these guys I can make more fuel packs. Yeah, let me make a couple of those guys there. So that'll convert the pellets into fuel packs, and then fuel packs can just like go in my generator, and then the generator powers my whole base. So these guys are probably done by now. All right, well, they're still cranking away here, but I will show you how this works. Okay, so this is the building process. Now, shipbuilding is very similar. It's just a little bit smaller scale, like individual blocks are smaller, but it's the exact same system as far as I know. So yeah, you can see I can move around here and it's giving me colors showing me where the block will go. So I can put one there, one there, one there. I've got a jetpack here. Let's see, I'm gonna try and hit J to turn my jetpack on. And I can fly up here a little bit, do a little flying around thing. So this is my, go away. This is the kind of the core of my base. If that gets destroyed, then I don't own the base anymore, and it's just free block floating out there. So I want to kind of protect that. So let's get this here. How many more? You can also do a very nice drag building thing here, too. Like, I can click, hold down, and drag across. Boom, and I just placed three blocks just like that. So we have a little 3x3 here now. Very nice, very shiny, very beautiful. All right. So I'm going to build some more of these, and then I'm also going to start building some of the more advanced things. Not advanced things. I'm going to build a large constructor, which is going to allow us to build faster and just quicker and do middle-tier components automatically. I'm going to build a small generator and a fuel tank, and these are going to require all sorts of these middle-tier components. I'm not going to bore you with me crafting them all because there's tons of them, but it's basically these right here, not the fuels, the steel plates, metal pieces, control devices, components, cables, glass plates, and electronics make all kinds of middle tier components like reactor cores and capacitor devices and motors and computers and just all this stuff. And then you use that to assemble the bigger thing. So I'm going to do all that now off camera and get these guys ready to go, and we'll get our base starting to cruise along here. And we are back, and that was a lot of crafting. That took some time here, but we're good. And I also made some more blocks here. So I want to extend my base into the water a little bit more here. So Like I said, you can do this like nice 3x3 here and lay down a whole ton of blocks at once. I think I'll actually do some over here now. I'll go along this whole side. Let's see. Right there, all the way down. Good. I only got one block left. So how's that looking up? I got too fat. Get up. Why is my jetpack off? Jetpack on. I wonder if it turns off automatically for some reason. Not sure. Okay, so we got a nice little platform here. Yeah, eventually we'll want to make this bigger, or like I said, we may even just move. But I've got the three things necessary for a base. I have a generator, so this big boy here, boo, he's going to supply power for the whole base. Now, he's just a small generator. There are large generators. Like, you can see already, the things we're placing are fairly massive, so it's going to take some time to, let's see, I want to put this guy... I can rotate them now, too. How is it? How did I do it? There we go. That's not really doing much, I guess. So he's going to hold my fuel cells, and the fuel cells are going to power the generator. So everything on the base, because it's all connected to this guy here, and like a continuous, you know, connected to the blocks, connected to the thing, it's all part of the same system. So the generator can supply things all over the place. Like, I can put this guy... Ugh, large constructor. This thing is massive. Okay, I want to put him there. And again, this is already too tight, but you can see the scale at which these bases are going to grow. It's going to be absolutely huge. Let me get some more light going here. I want to try and play with this little light here, maybe? Nope. Oh, it's got to be built. Okay, it can only go out there. I want to rotate this guy, maybe? Yeah, of course, it's only going to allow me to rotate it like that. And that doesn't help very much. Thanks, but no thanks. All right. Okay, hopefully it's not too dark here. I may have to wait until morning or... We'll see here, but we've got our oh, jeez, are you serious? I thought it was because, but, all right, so I was led to believe that, oh man, this is scary. Can we build, there's like turret. Is there a turret anywhere? Base? Come on. Where are the base defenses? Somewhere there's a turret that I can get in and just... destroy face, but I don't know that I'm gonna be able to make it in time. I'm looking at my radar there to see if this guy's gonna show up. No, it's got to be... Where is it? Somewhere in here. Ah! Okay, that's not working. Instead, we are gonna go to the tech tree real quick and let's see. Weapons, assault rifle. Do I have enough to unlock this? I don't. I don't have enough unlock points. I only have... How many unlock points do I have? Not enough. Oh, this is going to be bad, guys. This drone's going to come and it's going to kick our butt. Uh-oh. I don't see him on the radar yet here, though. Somewhere... Oh, I have to unlock... Okay, yeah, it's all about unlocking. So this is the tech tree. Meanwhile, while we wait to get waxed by this incoming drone that's going to kill us, I really want to unlock assault rifle. It requires... I have 10. Unlock. You... Unlock. Oh, I have to be level 3, too. And I am... What level am I? I have no idea what level I am. Tab? Where does it show my level? Unlock points... I'm level 2. Oh, man, I just gotta get a little bit more experience. I don't know. I think, like, farming some stuff? This is gonna be bad. Alright, let's see if we can find some stuff to farm real quick. I want to level up so I can get my assault rifle. If I can get my assault rifle, then I can fight off... the drone that's going to be coming very soon. Although, I don't know if he's just going to... Oh! I don't know what that is. I don't want to fight you people. Strange, indigenous, threatening people. They look kind of... Oh, there's more creepy people over here with spears. These guys are close to my base. I do not like this. Okay. This motorcycle handles like a potato. I don't know if I should get too close. I don't know if I should get too far from my base. I'm afraid of the drone just coming by and lighting up my base and not... Oh, okay. Yeah, I thought the drone attacks weren't supposed to start until I turned my base on, which, to my understanding, I didn't do. But, okay. Well, let's wait and see what happens. So, here he comes. Here he comes. Minigun drone coming in. Oh, this is not good. All right, let me see if I can hide behind my base here. Die. Oh, this is not good. Die! Oh, reloading. Go, hide behind the giant shield. Oh. Oh, what you got now? You can't shoot down, can you? Oh, this gun is so bad. Come on, buddy. Get back here. Not done with you. Oh, he's turning around. He's turning around. Here comes the pain. Oh, must seek shelter. Oh, yes. I was just starting to wonder if I was going to take this guy down. Oh, okay. Let's see what he's got. I can loot these guys now. F. All kinds of goodies. All right, you can bring more of those if you want to send any more of those care packages over. I don't mind. All right, let's wait till daytime. All right, day is breaking here. And actually, that drone attack, as you can see, brought me up to level 3. So I think I can go to weapons and unlock it. Yeah, okay, so it's light blue now. It shows it's available. Okay, let's unlock that guy. That's some pure happiness right there. Get rid of this stupid pistol. Yeah, my jetpack keeps turning off. I don't know what does it. All right, it probably only stays on for a little while. Maybe? Not sure. Whatever. All right, let's go in here now. And... oh, yes. Assault rifle. We have everything we need. Okay. I was creating more of these steel blocks here, but let's bump these guys down here because I want my... Oh, wait, is my base off? There we go. Got to turn my base on. So I hit Y to turn everything on. You can see, like, hitting Y turns the generator off, turns it back on again. I don't have to be looking at it. It's all kind of base aware. I have my fuel cells in here now, so that's going to power this guy, I believe. And yeah, he's done. So the assault rifle should be crafting now. Go ahead. There we go. Excellent. I'm going to put some more of these guys on here because I want to... oh, wait. These are different kinds. Oh, block S and block L. No idea what that difference are there. All right, whatever. Ain't got time for that. I do have time for this, though. But I gotta be careful here, so let's see here. I gotta make some ammo for this guy. So this takes, over on the right, you can see 5.8 millimeter bullets. Let's bank some of those out. There we go. Each one of these is gonna make 25, so okay, 8. So that'll give me 200 bullets. So let's let that crank. Oh, wants it. Oh, I can right click. I wonder if I can shoot a bird out of this guy. That would be pretty awesome. I don't think this has... I got no ammo for this yet, so I need to... is there like a view on me? Whoa. What just happened? I don't know what that was. I hit F5 and I went to some kind of crazy HUD mode. Was that my helmet? My helmet's off. Interesting. Okay, what I want to do... what I want to do is get these bullets done here. Alright, that should be enough. Let's just let these finish here. And we're going to go exploring a little bit. I want to show you a little bit more of the planet, and I want to show you mining real quick. So let's get these guys and hop on the motorcycle. Alright, let's go over to this magnesium vein here. You can see it's got a little bit of a thing. Shows us it's on the other side of this massive mountain, though, and I don't know that my little Fisher-Price motorcycle is going to make it over there. Let's try here. Let's see if we can get some speed here. These things have trouble on steep hills. Probably not going to make it up here. I got to like go back and forth here. See if I can do back and forth. Back and forth, maybe. Maybe up a slide over here. Maybe. Maybe I'll just go on an angle. Oh, it seems to be working. You can do it. Come on. This is probably like a cliff right here. I'm just gonna fall. Yep, fall to my death. That didn't help at all. Skidding. Help. Okay, let's keep going. Can we? What if we just try to do this? We're like way off target now, aren't we? Well, it's not bad. Oh, this motorcycle is horrible. Come on, over the hill. One more, and I think we're in the clear, and I can turn. Looks like the crest I could level out here. Okay, we're up by like this. Oh, wow, look at all this over here. Okay. Go! Oh, man. Okay. Where is it now? It's got to be right. Oh, okay, we got to turn left. Look at these trees. Love them. Absolutely beautiful trees. Okay. Oh, avoid trees. Avoid water. Avoid water. If you go in the water, you pretty much crash your bike and they have to like pick it up and it's all embarrassing and stuff. Alright, here we go. We're almost to this magnesium deposit. And I think I just used it for ammunition and stuff like that. So let's make sure no one's around here. Okay, looks like we're pretty close to it. You have to like look down. It's like it's actually like below the ground. So I just want to stand right on top of it, right here. Switch to my. Is it still on my bar here? Drill, yeah, drill. Okay. Right here. So let's just dig down right here. And once we get down there, you'll see. Oh look, it's already looks like it's changing. The texture of the ground changes. It's actually a really cool system here. So, alright, I've done a little bit here, and I think you can see, like, this is turning white here, and all these little rocks are appearing. I can hit F and collect these guys. So these are crushed stone. I can turn those into cement, and then turn those into, like, building blocks later. But right now, I think this is, the white stuff is magnesium. So the actual texture that you're blasting makes a difference. Like, if I blast here, I'm going to get magnesium. If I blast there, I'm going to get stone. Really cool stuff. So these should be magnesium. Yep, you can see it over there in the bottom left, plus two magnesium ore, plus magnesium ore. Awesome. So this is the mining process. It's actually kind of cool. I really like it, but you got to be careful. Like, you could dig yourself into a hole, and you can't get out. I mean, the jetpack helps a little bit, but yeah, there you go. I just popped right out. You can see the size of the hole I've already dug there. Really cool stuff. Permanent terrain deformation and everything. Now, I'm led to believe that later on there's automated mining systems I can, like, deploy down here, and they'll do their thing, and I'll come back and just pick up the goodness and be on my way. Really cool stuff there, but I just wanted to show you guys that is mining. So I think I'm gonna hop on my bike here and stroll around a little bit more, but I think that's gonna do it for today, guys. I hope you're enjoying this. Remember, if you enjoy this video, hit that like button. I would appreciate it. And if you're new to the channel, go ahead and subscribe, because there's gonna be a lot more Empyrion coming up. Let me know what you guys thought. I'll see you guys next time. It's Tango. I am out.